Okay, what we have here is an optical end stop, and it's a little unique. It's got written really small here, V, S, and G, and what they stand for is ground, signal, and voltage. So a little trick that I used is I put red for plus, black for minus, and then I know the center is going to be signal. So one of the tricks that you can use with this, there are a couple different ways to do this to make sure that you get it right, but the simplest one is to plug it in, extend the wire out, and follow the colors of the wire, and then mark them at the ends so that you get your red, your black, and your signal. Another way to do it would be use a multimeter. So let's review the pins real quick again. For the end stop pins, you have the X-min, the X-max, the Y-min, the Y-max, the Z-min, and the Z-max. In this case, we're going to do it on the Y max. So we're going to count down 4, 2, 3, 4. So red on signal, black on negative. So negative, positive, or I'm sorry, positive, negative, and then signal. So now that we've got them all lined up, we're going to attach the USB connector. Now this will run off USB just like the end stops in the previous video. And the optical end stop works slightly different in that you have to break in between these two with some kind of barrier to cause it to trip or actuate. So let me hook it up and I'll show you on the computer how it works.
Okay, I've opened up Pronterface. I'm gonna connect. Looks like it connected fine. Now keep in mind this was on Y max, so let's see what it says for M119. Right now it says Y min and Z min and Z max and Z min. So we've got to change it in the driver. So we're going to disconnect and we're going to open up Marlin in Studios. So 2 seconds. Okay, first thing we're going to check is under tools. Looks like the right board specified, right subtype of the board, and the port is selected. Let's go over to configuration, do a search on end stops. Okay. And it looks like YMAX is not specified. So we're going to uncomment it. Scroll down, see if there's anything else that needs to be changed. It looks like it's okay for the moment. So we're going to compile and upload to the Mega 2560. Okay, it's finished uploading. So we're going to go back to Pronterface. In Pronterface, we're going to reconnect. Looks like we connected fine. We're going to try M119 again. Now says that we have a WiMAX. And it says it's open. So with a little piece of paper, we're going to break the field in the optical sensor.
Okay, the field is broken. So we're going to go back over to Pronterface. And we're going to see what M119 says.
It says triggered. We'll move it out of the way. Now it says open. So that's how you do the optical mop. If you like my video, please press the like button and subscribe. I'll try and do a video every week. And thank you for watching.